Hawks are beautiful birds of prey. They're exciting to see, unless you're a chicken farmer.
So you're probably asking, what are your options when birds of prey stop by for a chicken dinner? Jack Hubley has the answer in tonight's Wild Moment.
Most mornings, I settle for cereal for breakfast. But on special mornings, when I have the time, I like to scramble a few eggs. And unlike Paul Burke, I never have to worry about a red-tailed hawk like Spike here coming between my breakfast and me. Paul writes, I have been attempting to raise chickens to offset the rising cost of eggs. We have a resident red-tailed hawk that has depleted my chicken population. Is it possible to have someone trap this hawk and relocate it so that I can get back to raising chickens? Paul, the short answer is no. It's not legal to trap and relocate red-tailed hawks, or any hawk for that matter. Most birds, and that includes birds of prey, songbirds, wading birds, and waterfowl, are protected by the Federal Migratory Bird Treaty Act. Now, if egg production was a major source of your income, you could apply for a permit to remove the offending bird by lethal means. But that would require the approval of three agencies: the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and the Pennsylvania Game Commission. And if you're producing eggs as a hobby, that's not even an option. So what can you do? Well, you might try some scare tactics. Bullseye balloons, pie tins, and other objects that wave in the wind can be effective. Owl decoys might work, but inanimate objects must be moved frequently to be effective. In my opinion, Paul, you need to fence your poultry operation. Hunting isn't a hobby for that red-tailed hawk. His life depends on catching and killing animals. To him, free-range chickens are fast food for hawks. So, building a pen for your chickens is the best way to keep those hawks out of trouble, and the best way to ensure a breakfast omelet at the Burke House. And, speaking of birds, concerning last week's story about why bird feet don't freeze in the winter, we here at News 8 do have our standards, and only the animals may appear naked on air. So, yes, I was wearing gym shorts beneath that big goose-down coat. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Janelle's question has been answered. If you have a problem with a predator, you can call the USDA Wildlife Services at 866-487-3297.
I was pretty sure he had a little something on.